Being a lifetime fan of boxing and its history, I made my way out to Little Manassa, Colorado, the birthplace of heavyweight champion of the world, Jack Dempsey. Dempsey's childhood home, a one-room cabin which is located in central Manassa, was uprooted and moved to the site of his memorial and made into a museum. Walking up to the humble estate made me consider Dempsey's rags-to-riches struggle and the hard work that went into becoming the boxing heavyweight champion of the world. William Harrison Dempsey was born on June 24, 1895, in Manassa, Colorado. The story of how he would become Jack Dempsey would not begin until he, his brothers, and his father would go from mining town to mining town to find work in order to support their impoverished family. It was in these mining saloons that he would pick up nighttime prize fights in order to make a little extra cash. He would never lose. He gave himself the name Jack, filling in to fight for his older brother one night, as he did not want people to know who he was. The name stuck, and the legend of Jack Dempsey was born. Jack was the top challenger in the year 1919. He had the chance of a lifetime when he was given the opportunity to fight heavyweight champion, the great white hope, 6'6" Jess Willard, for the title. Jack stood only 6'1", 187, and the task was daunting, but he could not let the chance slip away. This was his time, and he would work tirelessly to seize it.
Mid-ring, he's helpless. He's lost all coordination between brain and hand. His efforts are pitiful. He was big and good-looking and smiling when he came into the ring. Now he's a lurching, tottering wreck of a man. Dempsey beats at him, in the body, shifting his attack for a moment from that pitiful face. A new champion's being born here, born in the torrid heat among the yells of 70,000 spectators, born in blood and effort and pain. It's bad for Willard, taking the hammer blows of the ring's greatest puncher, but it's no picnic for the man who's winning either. His lungs strain, his heart beats in his throat, his arms are like lead, but still he carries on that deadly attack. He pours leather at the giant, who should have gone down long ago, who would have gone down, but for the heart of a lion and the endurance of a buffalo. Even the spectators are beginning to flinch at the sight. This is no fight, it's a slaughter, a massacre.
The fight that would make Jack Dempsey was nothing less than a good old-fashioned take-it-behind-the-woodshed beatdown, where the contender would continuously land bombs into the 6'6" Willard's ribs. The record crowd would be shocked as the undersized challenger would virtually dominate the heavyweight champion in every aspect of the fight. A one-room cabin. A poor family. A tough-as-nails kid with nothing to lose. Jack knocked out Willard in 3 rounds. Dempsey was now the boxing heavyweight champion of the world. The poor old farm boy from a small town in Colorado was now the king of New York and rolled with the likes of New York Yankees star George Herman Ruth. Does that name ring a bell? During his reign as heavyweight champion of the world, Jack would defend and protect his title 6 different times, a span that would range from 1919 to 1927. A knockout artist indeed. Dempsey would lose to Gene Tunney on a controversial 8 count in the final round in a heavyweight title match in 1927. Being a man of character that he was, Jack wasn't bitter and graciously accepted the defeat. Dazed and hardly able to stand up straight, Jack told his trainer to carry him over to Tunney's corner just to shake his hand. What a class act he was. Jack would die on May 31st, 1983, an icon in the boxing world and a superhero in the San Luis Valley. Although he's buried in New York, his statue stands high in the front yard of the house that he grew up in Little Manassa. Even at the height of his career and fame, Jack never abandoned his hometown and always came back to visit. His spirit still runs deep here, inspiring all those who want to follow in his footsteps.